So, good evening from Madeira. This is the third video in my little series on photographing Madeira. And yeah, I've changed location. I'm no longer on the northwestern part of the island. Now made it to the east. And yeah, the east is very different in terms of vegetation, as you can see. So if you remember, the first two videos was all green, thick vegetation. And here, this Ponta de San Lorenzo, or however it's called, it's very brownish, very dry, but it's also very spectacular and beautiful. As you can see behind me, steep cliffs, sunrise this direction, and I made it up here for sunset just to do a little scouting trip. But just as I arrived, there was a rainbow, a double rainbow even, over the Ponta, or yeah, this part of the island, and it was just great. I couldn't film it. I just quickly got out the camera as I got up here, took a few photos, and I'll show you in a second. But yeah, sometimes you're just lucky, and I hope the photos turned out nice. Well, for now, I'm just continue to scout a little bit, but my real mission is to buy groceries. I just snuck in this little scouting session, and yeah, it was a good decision. So always scout the places. I mean, it's easy to find photo spot. You have this structure, you can see it down from the path, and then there's a little path up here. But I guess in the dark it could be a bit hard, so it's always good to come to a place you want to photograph in the morning, in the evening, or the day before, even around noon, whatever. So I'm always repeating this: scouting is important. And yeah, maybe tomorrow or the next days I go here. And I also want to use this third video, or maybe there will be even a fourth video, but to show you Pico Aiero, the mountains. But currently you see clouds all around them, and I hope this changes the next days. Maybe I get an inversion and can drive up there in the morning and really show you the beautiful views from up there. I've seen photos and it's really spectacular, and I hope to experience it myself. But for now, I'm just glad to have at least gotten one photo from here already. And yeah, now I have to really make it to the store, buy something. My girlfriend's already waiting. So yeah, see you the next days photographing this part of the island. So it's now 12 hours later, and I'm back at the photo spot which I scouted yesterday. I've already taken a couple of photos because 20 minutes ago it looked quite nice in the background with dark clouds, and I could do some long exposures to capture the movement. Also, if you look down there, there's a lot of action in the water, so long exposures turn this surf into a beautiful painting. And I have to be a bit careful now, wind's picking up and I don't want to lose my camera, so I'm holding it. Here's also a tip: so if you're shooting at such a location where there are gusts of wind coming and you want to do long exposures, either you have to try to place your tripod very low, or you weigh it down. But as I said in another video, weighing it down always creates those little shakes even when there are those gusts. So what you can, in addition to that, do when you take the photo: position yourself as a wind blocker so that most of the wind is blocked by you and not so much gets to the camera. Because most of the wind will be received up here. So the tripod, it's just thin legs. They won't, the wind will just flow around them. But here the wind's hitting, this moves everything. So shield this area from the wind while you're taking the exposure, and this might help. Not always, sometimes the wind is just unpredictable going everywhere, but yeah, here it worked quite nice, I think. So at least zooming in on the images, they look sharp. So that's also a thing: always check your images and take many photos, because those gusts of wind in between, you might get a good photo. Sometimes just spray and pray helps. Yeah, I'm now just sticking around a bit longer. Maybe the sun comes out, should be in like 15 minutes. I'm not sure if it will be spectacular, because yeah, it might be. But there are still some clouds very low at the horizon, which delay the sunrise. But once the sun gets over, and also if you look in that direction, a lot of dark clouds. I'm not sure in which direction they're moving, but this could create quite some nice light, and maybe I also head to another viewpoint. But now, enough waffling. just enjoy the morning and maybe take one more photo. Good morning, another day of shooting here in Madeira, and I have to say the last 2 days haven't been too productive in terms of photography. There was a lot of rain and wind, and really the wind was the problem. It was very strong, very gusty, so I didn't take many photos, but I explored some areas. One of those, this spot here, this viewpoint of the Ponta São Lourenço, which you see in the background. This is where I was photographing the first day. And yeah, now I've come to this spot, which is a little farther inland, or not inland, so it's also at the coast, but farther west. And it's beautiful because of all those rocks around me. So those create a nice foreground interest, which complements the background. So the sea stack in the background, it's kind of a repetition of this rock here and also those smaller rocks on the side, and that's always good looking for repetition. So yeah, I'm now just waiting for the right light, because currently the sky is not ideal. There's clouds at the bottom, then a big bright gap which doesn't look nice, so either this gap fills with clouds or I just wait till the sun pops above the clouds in the background and bathes this scenery into warm light. So this is really what I'm hoping for, but yeah, really I think I have to wait for at least 20 to 30 minutes. Yeah, for now, that's all about the photo. I have two filters in front of a lens, so a two-stop hard edge, two-stop soft edge from Kase to balance the exposure later on, and then, yeah, it's now just waiting and hopefully taking some photos. So the clouds now moved in and I've modified the composition a bit, and yeah, now I thought I'd quickly talk you through the composition about what I was saying with repetition. So let's just do that. I'll record here on the camera. And let's see that it's not too dark. So the colors will be a bit different maybe, but let's just do this. So what you see here, I excluded the big sea stack which was here in the video I filmed before, and now we have all those little, yeah, what's called those nicely shaped rocks here, all at an angle, and also here. So there's a lot of repetition here in the foreground. And then what you see here in the background, this sea stack kind of is a repetition of those. So you have this one, then a smaller one, then even smaller one, then here in the background, the smallest one. So I think that's kind of nice. And also I'm now added a polarizer instead of just using the graduated filters. I also have the polarizer to, let me just turn it, to make sure the coast, not the coast, the water is nice blue. And now the only thing I need is a bit of light to make this foreground even more interesting. So in the background, if you see, there's already some rays of light breaking through the clouds. But here in the foreground, clouds are still quite thick. But what usually happens, maybe 10, 20 minutes after sunrise, the clouds disperse a bit. At least this is what was happening the last days. And I hope this theme continues here and I get some nice light, sun breaking through the clouds. But already like this, it looks nice. So really beautiful morning, and yeah, I hope the photo shows that beauty, the beauty of this place, also with the coast in the background. I didn't get the light I was hoping for that morning, but I liked the scene so much that I returned the next morning, which is when magic happened.